Hi, welcome to my new Forex Trading Simulator spreadsheet. This spreadsheet is a little bit similar to another spreadsheet that I have that I call a Stock Trading Simulator, of which perhaps you have seen a few videos already. This spreadsheet helps you simulate trading in a Forex environment. The prices are real-time and they are coming from the TrueFX provider. Let me click on the Start Live button so that you can see how the FX rates are coming into my spreadsheet. I do that now. And I have set it to receive feeds on a 1 second time interval. Now, the interesting part is that the history of these FX rates are reported on the chart that you see here on the top. The blue line on the bottom corresponds to the bid prices, and the red line corresponds to the ask prices. Now, underneath in the yellow area, you see under live TrueFX price monitor, a few FX rates on the left column that are reported. If I scroll down, you can see all of them. And the columns that you see, they report from left to right the so-called bid big, which is basically the portion of the bid price that changes less frequently, followed by the bid pips or points, which are the digits on the far right of the bid price that change all the time, as you see actually here. And then the remaining columns are the similar quantities about the ask price, followed by the high, low, open. And then you have the complete bid and ask rate and a timestamp. Okay, it will be a little bit easier if I hide a few columns on the right that are not so important, so we have more viewing space. Let me go to the sheet called Configure. And here in my Configure screen, for example, I have the fields that I can toggle out. So if I untick the high, the low, open, bid, ask, and last updated. So I'm not going to see these fields anymore. Before I go back, and first, of course, I have to press the Apply button, let me show you quickly that here you can enter the tact, which is basically the time interval between successive updates. I have it to the lowest, which is 1 second, but you can change to another value here. Then I have a transaction fee, which is set to 5 whatever units of whatever the currency, the account currency is going to be. I'm going to change that to 0 because most Forex brokers do not apply a transaction fee as they earn their money from the bid offer spread. Then this is quite interesting here, the buffer size currently set to 20. Now if you move the mouse here, you can see some information how this is defined. And this basically 20 means that the most recent 20 quotes are kept in memory and they are being displayed in Excel. I will change that to 200, have more of them, why not? And the buffer update tells you basically, you can define here whether you want to skip some of the quotes as they come and not retain them inside the buffer. Now by setting one means we do not skip any of them. Now here in the monitor tickers, you can choose the tickets that you want to monitor. For example, I have Euro USD, USD versus Japanese Yen, GBP USD. I can have also non-USD Forex pairs, like Euro GBP or Euro Japanese Yen. I can add one more like that, Japanese GBP, British Pounds, Japanese Yen. And then these are all the currency pairs that are available. Now, on the P&L account, you can change here to any of these currencies. I'm going to keep US dollar, which is basically the denomination currency on which my proceeds from trading are calculated, reported. In other words, this is the account that I open with my broker. Initial margin is 1,000, of course, in units of the account currency on the top. So this is $1,000. This is the money that I invest with my broker before I start trading. And the leverage that I have agreed with my broker is 100, which means for every $1 that I spend, my broker is going to put another $99 to reach a total of $100 that I can commit towards a trading transaction. Okay, here you define the lot types. So every time I buy or sell a lot, because this is how it works, I'm not going to buy or sell, for example, 30 currency units, but I'm going to buy or sell one or two or three lots. And here is how the size of each lot is defined. So we're going to use most of the time the mini lot, which corresponds to 10,000 units of the foreign currency on which we trade. Okay, now if I hit apply, as you see, the columns have been disappeared on the right of the ask pip, so you can see only four columns now, the bid big, bid pips, ask big, and ask pips. So that give us a little bit more space on the right to see the table which holds the aggregated transactions per ticker. It is empty now because we have not placed any transaction yet. Now here on the chart, you can see how the quotes now are being updated because we decided to increase the buffer size to 200. So I'm going to have, again, the red line on the top is the ask prices, the ask quotes, and the blue line is the bid quotes. Now, these prices are not only on the chart, but if you scroll here on the right, you can see on this yellow area, the latest quotes, they are reported on the spreadsheet. If you scroll down, you can go actually to the very first how they get updated. You can see each second, basically the last pair is pushed downwards because the most recent pair, it's added on the top of these two columns. And when this reaches the end, which is down here, nothing bad is going to happen. If I scroll back to the top, the only thing is that the top rows will be kept updated with the most recent bid and ask quotes, and everything else will be pushed underneath below that. Okay, now let me place my first transaction. Here you can see that my account is US dollar. The lot type, I can change that, standard, mini, micro, or nano, but I set to mini, which means if I trade one lot, effectively, I'm going to trade 10,000 currency units. So the ticker is here, and I'm going to choose, if I click here, I can select any of these three that I'm allowed to commit a transaction. There must be on a US dollar currency on the denominator, that's a so-called quote currency. So I'm going to choose Euro USD. And here I can enter the number of lots that I can trade. For example, I can enter two lots. So you see underneath the target size is 20,000 units. That means 20,000 euros. Now, here on this little box here, you can see a few more details. So the base currency is Euro. The quote currency is USD. And then you have here the quotes right now as they keep changing every second. The pips, for example, if I want to buy, I have to pay 362 pips right now. And if I want to sell, I have to accept through 358 pips. And the complete Euro USD FX rate is underneath. You can read that here. And the total, 24,000, is how much I have to pay in USD dollars if I want to commit a buy transaction. And the other one is the respective amount if I want to sell. Now, the margin requirement is $241, which is the amount that I need to have in order to proceed with my two lots transaction. And I do have this amount because my remaining margin is right now 1,000. I have not made use of any of my initial 1,000 account holding. And each time a pip goes up or down, a pip changes by one unit, the respective P&L is 2.41. So $2.41. I'm starting to gain or lose each time the FX rate changes by one pip. So let me buy 20,000 euros right now. I click on buy. And you see the transaction has been reported in the aggregated transactions per ticker table here. So I have a total on the top row, and the individual transaction is a euro USD, which is 20,000 euros. They are in my possession, that's positive. I bought them, and zero fee. And the realized profit is so negative because it's a cost. I had to pay this amount in dollars in order to receive my 20,000 euros. The live price is actually the price that I'll have to use if I would like to liquidate my position. So because if I have to sell the euros back to the market, I have to accept the bid price. So 1.2354, 357 right now is the bid price on the euro USD rate. And the current value that I would achieve if I were to sell my position is 24,000. So the book profit right now is minus $1.60. So let me buy another currency. I don't need to concentrate only on Euro USD. I can even have, let's say, GBP USD. I'm going to buy British pounds. Let's say I've changed that to one lot this time. So hit the buy button to buy. As you see, before I hit the buy button, here everything has changed. This little box area, it shows now the base currency being GBP, and the code currency is always USD. And the information underneath now relate to the GBP-USD exchange rate. If I click on the buy, I have another row here on GBP-USD. I have 10,000 British pounds. And my book profit is actually, it went positive for a little bit. Now it's at 10 US dollar cents, actually, 10 cents of a dollar negative. You can commit a second transaction. So if I click another buy, again, with the same FX rate, all has happened, that has happened is that in under the aggregated transactions per ticker here, my position of the GBP per USD has increased to 20,000. And I keep doing that. I buy again, and that became now 30,000 British pounds that I hold. And this is my aggregated P&L is minus 70 cents on the GBP payer and minus $4 on the Euro USD payer. And here my total book profit or P&L so far is minus 220 on both of these currencies. Now I can sell, let's say I'm going to sell now one lot on GBP pair. I hit on the sell button. I did, and what has happened is that my position has decreased from 30,000 down to 20,000. And you can see all these transactions if you go to the ledger sheet. I hit here, and here in that table you can see the timestamp, the size, the price, the fee if there is any, and the cost of each individual transaction that I have committed so far. So I go back to my simulator. and let me close all my positions in both currencies. So I'm going to sell a change out to two. I'm going to sell two lots on the British pound USD currency pair, and that brought the total size to zero. So the book profit, $6.20, is the final one. This cannot change over the time anymore. And then I move my currency pair to Euro USD, and because I hold two lots, I'm going to sell these two lots. I hit on the button now, and I closed my position as well. And okay, I was lucky today. I made a profit out of this round trip. So I bought two currencies, and then I sold these two currencies, and I made a profit of $4.60, as you see here. Of course, you can imagine that I have used a lot type, not mini, but here if I had done all this thing with the standard lot, that will be my profit 10 times more, because a standard lot is based on 100,000 units, which is 10 times more than the mini lot, which is only 10,000 units. So I would have now a profit of $40.60. Of course, that could have been a loss if the market had moved on a different direction. Okay, before I close, let me reiterate an important aspect, that since you have the latest quotes here on the spreadsheet, the bid and the ask, you can write your own custom Excel formulas that somehow calculate this time evolution of these quotes. For example, they calculate the average or the standard deviation or any other of intelligent comparison that you can use to build your own trading signals that can tell you basically based on the shape of the chart of the bid and the offer prices, whether that would be a good time to buy and sell. And you can use this trading simulator to test the efficacy of your own trading signals. That brought me to the end of this talk. Thank you for watching.